you've been battling with fear, take a moment, memorize this scripture, and I'm going to help equip you with how to fight fear in the spirit.
We all have to deal with fear.
I mean, if you're stepping in faith in obedience to what God is telling you to do, fear is always going to try and creep in. And it's really not, it doesn't mean that you don't have enough faith or that something's wrong with you. It probably means you're doing something right. So sometimes we can become so inundated with fear that we either forget or never learned how to fight against it. And so the point of me sharing this is to help equip you with scripture to be able to fight this. But also, I'm going to quickly tell you how you can ask the Holy Spirit in to reveal to you what is causing the fear and to reveal the truth to you. I want you to memorize 2 Timothy 1:7. I'm going to read it in the NLT version, but whatever version you understand and whatever version you can remember, that's the version you go with. For God has not given us a spirit of fear and timidity, but of power, love, and self-discipline. The important part about this is we need to remember God's word. God's word is the truth. So if I'm feeling shy, if I'm feeling scared, if I'm feeling panic, terror, anxious, anything, I need to remember the truth. And what is the truth? Well, it's right here. And I'll read it in the Message version. God doesn't want us to be shy with his gifts, but bold and loving and sensible. That's incredible. And you say, well, does it matter which version? No, it doesn't. To whatever speaks to you, whatever you can remember. But I can always remember that God has given us a spirit of boldness and not of timidity, not of fear. And that's kind of what comes to me. And so you remind yourself of that truth and that scripture. Okay, hold on. For God has not given us a spirit of timidity, but of a spirit of boldness and of self-discipline. Hold on for a second. That's the truth. Okay, and if fear does not back off, you take your stand against fear. Okay, you are not allowed to come at me. In the name of Jesus, you are not allowed to come at me, fear. This is the truth. This is what God's word says. So back up and be quiet in the name of Jesus. Come up against that spirit of fear. Fear is not allowed. So it's not enough to know the truth. You've then got to stand up to the enemy, and you do have to say it out loud. You know who you are. You're a child of God. You walk in the power and authority of Jesus Christ. And because of that, fear is not allowed to come inside. Fear is not allowed anymore. Back up, get out, be quiet in the name of Jesus. Say it out loud. You have to say it out loud. You got to be forceful. And as I was recently taught by someone who has been in the game for 50 plus years, shout out to Michael Cotton. You do need to do an actual movement. It's going to help. It's going to help because it's not just something that you think. This is what you believe. This is what you live. You're a child of God. So back up. Be quiet in the name of Jesus. And I'm telling you, that is going to change your life. It's changed my life. And if you're still having a problem with fear, ask the Holy Spirit to reveal the truth to you about that fear. What is the fear? Okay, I'm feeling fear. Are there any other emotions? Okay, God, reveal the truth to me. Why am I feeling this? And if you get a memory that comes up, ask Jesus to walk around in your soul, invite him in the memory. What's going on? Is there something that you're wanting to point out? Something that maybe got seated in my soul, a lie that could be attached to this fear, something like that. And ask God to reveal the truth to you. And when the Holy Spirit reveals the truth, he will set you free of this lie. Scripture says, who the Son sets free is free indeed. So yes, we're free in Christ. When we become Christians, that's it. We belong to God, right? So we're adopted in through Christ. But what's not immediately severed are all the things that got seated in before we became a Christian. And if you say, I've been a Christian my whole life, okay, but how long have you been really walking with God? Because in that time, you could have given ground to the enemy too. And even as Christians, when we're walking with the Lord, you know, we're really, our hearts are after God, we can still open doors to the enemy, whether it's through, you know, demonic, the occult or other things, or sometimes we come into agreement with lies that a lot of times happen in our childhood, in trauma, maybe someone spoke it over us. I mean, just all kinds of stuff. So I want to help you with this because fear is one of those things that we all have to deal with and you can't really escape it. So if it has become, if there is a lie attached to that fear, that's going to be when you're coming against with the word of God, which is the truth. The revealed word is going to be the only thing that really sets you free if there is a lie attached to it. If it's just something that you're really plagued with, and then if you don't hear anything, you may need to look at whether or not you need to forgive someone. And the best question to ask yourself is, who am I mad at? Who has wronged me that I've maybe just gone, it's okay, because that's not forgiveness. And we do it so often and we don't realize that's just not forgiveness. We actually have to say out loud, I forgive the person's name. If you can do the full name, perfect. I forgive them for what they did, when they did it, in the name of Jesus. God, release them, erase their name from whatever list you got going on of offenses. God, I want them completely scrubbed from any kind of anything. I want them completely redeemed from it. Just, I release them in the name of Jesus. I pray blessings over them. You can pray God to reveal the truth to them. But then you can go back in and God will speak to you. But sometimes you won't hear anything because you need to forgive. Sometimes we need to sit down with our pastor or leadership to do this as well. But I think just in general, this scripture, 2 Timothy 1:7, this is a great baseline scripture. This is the truth. God has not given us a spirit of shyness or a spirit of timidity, fear, any of that. So you know it's not from God. I know it's not. Why? Because God's word says that. So memorize that scripture, get it in your heart, but also just memorize it so you can go, hey, this is the truth. And then you can ask God to reveal the truth to you after you've taken your stand, after you've said, get out in the name of Jesus, fear. You cannot come inside. The Holy Spirit dwells within me. You can't come in here. You can stay out there, but you have to be quiet and get out in the name of Jesus. And you do that, you still have a problem. You need to ask God to reveal to you what's going on. And He will. He loves you so much, He will. But I just wanted to equip you with that scripture real quick, with a little bit of a process you can do with the Holy Spirit. Because the spiritual war is real. Now, Jesus has already won the war. We don't have to wonder. And so it's not something that you need to be afraid of when I talk about spiritual warfare, but it's real. And that's why the fear is coming at you, because God loves you, because you're a child of God. The enemy does not like that and does not like the call on your life, doesn't like what he's asking you to do, what you will do. And usually attacks of fear get really, really bad as you are about to do something really important with God. So I would encourage you to study this scripture. Is this the only scripture about fear? Absolutely not. But I hope that this is a great starting point for you. So what does the word of God say about fear? What does the word of God say about you and what God has given you? Well, we know that God has not given us a spirit of fear, timidity, or shyness, but of power, of love, and of self-discipline. God has given you that. So receive that truth today in the name of Jesus. I hope that this will help equip you as you move forward in what God is asking you to do with Him to further His kingdom in the name of Jesus. I encourage you to like and subscribe so that you never miss another Bible study and you never miss an opportunity to be equipped as a child of God.